Okay, we will start. So today's session is about ventilatory graphics or waveforms. Those who are listening this session, I will recommend listen to basics of mechanical ventilation lecture previously, whose link is in the description, or you can go browse the playlist. Today we are only going to discuss the normal waveforms on ventilator. There are lots of waveforms which are coming on the screen. We are not going to discuss what during troubleshooting or during alarms, what changes happens in the waveforms. For that, we'll take one more session in which we will discuss the troubleshooting and alarms. In that, we'll discuss how the waveform changes. But for them, you need to understand how are the ventilatory waveforms formed. How many are they? How to interpret them? What is actually going on them? Because why it is important, the values which are written on the ventilator, they lag approximately 6 to 8 breaths as compared to the waveform which are coming on the ventilator. So by looking at the ventilator waveforms, you can understand what is happening with the patient, what is happening with the lung compliance, whether there is auto PEEP or whether proper tidal volume is being generated or not, whether more flow is required or not. So we'll try to keep it simple. Those who are listening or viewing, what I am writing on the board is not important. What we are discussing, that is important. If at all you are not able to see what we are drawing it here, don't worry. We'll produce a lecture with screen recording also for that. So firstly, I will tell you the shapes of waveform. There are four types. One is square. Square waveform. Second is ascending type. Okay, this is ascending type. Third is descending type. And fourth is sine wave. So only these four types of waveforms are there on the ventilator. One is square, one is ascending, third is descending, and fourth is sine wave. We call it ramp also. These are ramp forms, and you can see on the ventilator. So only these four types of waveforms you will see on the ventilator scheme. Okay. Now, before understanding these waveforms, let us see what is actually ventilator doing with the patient. All the things come to delivering a single breath comfortably to the patient. So there are three parameters which you need to understand before going into detail. One is volume, second is pressure, and third is flow. So this is a ventilator tubing. One limb gets connected to your ventilator and the other limb gets connected to patient. So one is, it has one inspiratory limb and one is expiratory limb. So what the ventilators do, it blows the air, a certain amount of volume of the air goes into the patient. That is tidal volume. First thing, the main purpose is to deliver the breath. Now, whenever that ventilator blows this air to this ventilatory circuit, it generates a pressure. It generates a pressure that will be positive pressure. We are breathing in a negative pressure environment. We suck the air. But ventilator, what ventilator is doing? It is pushing the air into the ventilator. So ventilator, today's ventilator works on the positive pressure ventilation. They blows the air. Okay. So one is volume which is being delivered, second is the pressure inside the tube, and third the movement of the air, which we call is flow. With how much velocity, how much per unit of time, how much the airflow changes, it is known as flow. How much flow? So on the graph there will be positive deflection, negative deflection will tell, but any flow towards the patient is considered positive. If you are blowing to the patient, means in inspiration we are pushing the air towards the patient, so it will be a positive flow. And during expiration there will be a flow, but it will be towards the ventilator, so it will be considered as negative. It doesn't mean the ventilator circuit don't have any flow. If it is in the negative direction, it means the flow direction is reversed, it is towards the ventilator. So anything, any air flow direction towards the patient is considered positive, that means flow. And towards the ventilator is considered negative. So flow will be positive in your inspiration and flow will be negative in your expiration. This much clear? So these three variables are clear. Volume, we are delivering a volume with a certain amount of pressure. When we blow something, amount of air goes into the patient with a certain pressure and with a flow. I can push the air like this, and I can push this like same amount of, I am pushing the same amount of air, but the flow is different in this, both the things. So flow, volume, pressure and flow, these are the three variables which will keep on changing in different vein forms. So you need to understand these concepts. Now before we jump into understanding all these graphics, let's understand a single breath graph. Single breath graph means we'll see how a single breath is delivered to the patient. This the graph which I will draw, it's for understanding, not the actual graph. After that we'll jump onto all the what types of graphs are there. So this is your baseline, and suppose this is your start of inspiration. Inspiration remains for a certain period of time, then expiration. Now see, this graph denotes for hypothetical purpose, for understanding. Here the inspiration is starting, so consider it, it can be a flow graph or pressure graph. Just I am trying to teach you certain variables which will come in. The patient is at rest here, the ventilator is at rest, baseline ventilator is at rest. Here what happens, it starts the inspiration, it start to push the air inside the patient's lung. Now this point where the inspiration start, something should be there which will tell the patient that now it's time for you to push the air into the patient. I need to inspire, so I need to take breath. We are taking because our centers are coming, but what will tell the ventilator? So the thing which tells the ventilator at this point that you should push the air to the, you should deliver a breath to the patient through the ventilator circuit is called trigger. So this trigger will vary according to a modes. So the thing which is telling the ventilator that this is the thing you should push, now the time is there, you should push the breath into the patient, then this is called trigger. Now inspiration starts here, inspiration continues, and at this point inspiration ends and your expiration starts. Now suppose I am being triggered by a ventilator, the ventilator starts to put the air, at which point it should stop? At certain point it should stop, na? Certain thing in the ventilator should tell that now inspiration is okay, don't push, other will lung will blow out. So something should be there in the ventilatory circuit which will tell now it's the time to stop. So that variable which cycles the breath from inspiration to expiration is called cycle. Here it is called trigger, then cycle. Cycle change variable means the cycle of inspiration and expiration, end of inspiration and start of expiration. So that parameter which changes the which changes inspiration to expiration means at the end of inspiration tells the ventilator now it's okay, you should switch to expiration. That is called cycle. And one more is limit. Limit doesn't do with the change in inspiration or expiration, but it remains constant, it limits the breath during this dead period. We'll see with this example. You got this point? This is trigger, this is cycle, and the thing which remains, which limits the breath, certain parameter in the breath is called limit factor. Now as you have seen in the previous lectures, in control mode ventilation, volume control. Volume control mode, what does it do? So those who are listening, again I am saying, before listening to this session, please go and see the full lecture on basics of mechanical ventilation. Only then you will be able to understand. Now in volume control ventilation, we have in control mode, in volume control mode, we have fixed the amount of tidal volume which should be delivered to the patient. How much amount we have fixed? 450, suppose 450 mLs, means in every breath 450 ml air has to be pumped into the patient lung. And we have set it to suppose 10 breaths for the sake of learning. 10 breaths. 10 breaths in 60 seconds. So every 6 seconds, the ventilator will push the air. So in volume control, in control mode ventilation, in volume control mode, trigger will be time. Every 6 seconds, it will pump an air into the patient body. You got my point? Trigger will be here, time. Ventilator will understand that every 6 seconds I have to push the air. If I increase the respiratory rate to 20, then it will push the air after every 3 seconds. So this is the trigger. In volume control mode, the trigger is time. In volume assist control, means when the pressure generates a little bit of negative pressure, and then the breath is delivered. So in that case, the trigger will be patient. It's not the time, it's the patient. But just saying the patient won't work. It means negative flow in the tube. Patient will suck the air, so the flow will become negative, pressure will become negative, and there will be a certain amount of flow into the tubing. So that tubing flow or that drop in the pressure will trigger. So in assist control mode, this trigger will be patient driven negative deflection in the pressure or flow towards the patient. Do you understand what is the trigger means? Time we are fixed, correct? Then cycle. What will tell the ventilator that I should end this here? In control mode, volume control. How will the ventilator know now it's time I should stop the breath? Of matlab inspiration should end here. What is the target we have given in the control mode? Volume control, we have given 450 tidal volume should be there delivered to. So trigger started, ventilator start pushing the air, and once it reaches 450 ml, it stops. Now my work is over for this breath, I should stop. So cycle will be volume. So at 450 volume, it will switch to exhalation mode, to expiration mode. Inspiration will end and expiration will start. This you are getting clear? And cycle, you understand? Okay. Now limit. What is limited? What is limited during this? Then in this whole cycle, we have limited the flow. That flow rate should be like this. That's why it will push the air through a constant flow rate. This is. It will blow. Understood? It starts the patient, it starts the trigger. It will blow with a constant flow rate. And when the tidal volume reaches 450, it will cycle. So trigger is time, limit is the thing which is constant in, is during that cycle, and cycle is the end of inspiration and start of expiration. This is the cycle is the parameter which switches from inspiration to expiration. So you understood the concept of trigger, limit and cycle? Yes, got this point? One more thing remaining, I forgot. This is the expiration phase. This is the expiration phase. Right? This is inspiration started, it remained for a certain period of time, switched to expiration. Means it, we have, this is the time period, hai na? Pressure drop, and this is expiration till next breath start. Inspiration phase, ye wala, this one, and this is expiration. Got this? Understood this? Inspiration, expiration. Now, we will see what are the type of graphs. Practically,
limit or flow rate. मतलब उसमें डिफरेंस क्या होगा लिमिट और फ्लो रेट? मतलब फ्लो रेट एक कांस्टेंट हो जाता है, लिमिट हो गई क्या?
नहीं नहीं. What I'm telling, there are three parameters. One is trigger, what will tell the ventilator to trigger the inspiration. One is cycle, which will cycle the from inspiration to expiration. Limit is in during that breath, which is the parameter you have made constant during this period. We have limited the flow. We don't want the flow to be very high, to be very low. That you can change. I have just given an example of volume control. In assist control, these parameters change. In pressure control, these parameters change. Then by more different modes of ventilator, they changes. Just to introduce the concept of all these three variables, I have explained you. Okay. Now we'll discuss types of graphs. So there are two types of graphs, scalars and loops. So we have three parameters here, three graphs here and two loops here. All scalars means they are on x-axis, they are compared against the time. One axis is there, if we have two axes, this will always be time. Okay? This will be always be time. And loops, both these three parameters are compared among themselves. We have three parameters, we have volume, pressure and flow. Okay? So likewise our graphs will be volume, time graph, pressure, time graph means scalar, and this will be flow, time. So these three will be your scalar, three graphs: volume time graph, pressure time graph and flow time graph. And in loops, they are among themselves. The two loops which are there, pressure, volume and flow, volume. Only these five graphs are there, which covers 99.99% of all the ventilator graphics. All things move around these five graphs. Out of these loops, we don't use much in a regular practice, especially the flow volume loop. We at times use pressure volume loop. It helps in COPD or restrictive or obstructive lung diseases. But these three graphs you must know, scalars: volume time graph, pressure time graph and flow time graph. These shapes changes in different modes, in control mode, whether it's a volume control mode or it's a pressure control mode. Okay? Now we'll see these three graphs simultaneously. What is happening with the patient? So we'll put the flow in between, pressure above and volume below. Okay, so this is your flow chart, this is your pressure one and this is your volume. Okay, now we'll see a single breath what will happen to all these things. Suppose in control mode ventilation, in which we have fixed the flow. Flow is constant. Hello? Flow is constant. Now what we will see, we'll start with the flow and then we'll jot down the volume, pressure one and volume one. Suppose the time has triggered a breath. So in volume control mode, the every 6 seconds or every 3 seconds, whatever you have fixed on the ventilator, a breath is triggered. So here there will be a constant flow, means ventilator will this time. Now like this flow will remains constant against the time. So whatever flow we have set, we are not writing the value, it will confuse. So whatever flow we have set, it will remain constant throughout the cycle of inspiration. So it will come like this square form. But in pressure from here, as soon as you blow, because in the lung now the pressure will increase, it will constantly increase, airway and alveoli pressure will increase. So graph will be linear, sort of this, or slightly like this. So constant, it will reach to a peak. Clear? And tidal volume is also increasing. So tidal volume will also increase like this. Thick. Now what happens at the end of expiration? At the expiration, when the cycle 450 tidal volume has been delivered, the pressure with flow will drop. Now I'll draw it here so that it doesn't confuse. Now this is inspiration, and now in exhalation what will happen, the flow will revert back. Now the movement of the air will be from patient to ventilator. So it will come down. And now it will go like this. So correct? So this is a flow time graph. We started the inspiration. The flow during the inspiration remains constant. Then the flow get reverted. Now towards the ventilator, the air is coming. But this cannot be kept constant by the ventilator. The amount of exhalation depends upon how the patient lung is there, how the airway are behaving, whether they are bronchospasm or they are emphysematous chest. It depends on them. So the exhalation will follow this path. Okay. But here what will happen? Pressure. Now the pressure will drop. There is movement of the air, but the pressure will drop like this. Or sorry, it will not be like this. It will be like this. There will be a constant drop in the pressure. It will come first. You are seeing for the first time. That's why. But tidal volume will not be negative. Still there is something in the but tidal volume will start decreasing, so it will come like this. This you are getting what I am telling you. There will be three dynamic variable changes in a single breath. One is your volume which is being delivered to the patient. One is the pressure generated in the system, and the other is the flow. Now pressure, to understand the pressure, first let's see understand the pressure. Pressure is of the airway. The pressure is of the airway and there is of the lung. So the combined pressure of the lung, alveoli, parenchyma and the airway, what you call is PIP, peak inspiratory pressure. This will be the peak inspiratory pressure. You got my point? This one, this is the peak inspiratory pressure. Now out of this pressure you need to see what is the airway pressure and what is the plateau pressure. Plateau pressure means the pressure which is exerted, which is required to keep the alveoli open. That is called, we call plateau pressure. So how we can measure? When we restrict the movement of the air during inspiration in the airway. See, whatever we have pushed the air, now we need to put and hold here so that the whatever air will not move in the airway, whatever pressure is there of the alveoli. So what we do, we do an inspiratory pause. We do an inspiratory pause, and when we do an inspiratory pause, this is an inspiratory pause. The pressure falls and remains constant for a particular period of time. This point is plateau pressure. Whenever we are blowing inside the from the ventilator to patient, the pressure in the airway and the alveoli increases. That's why it's a gradual rise. Flow remains constant, but the pressure will gradually rise. It's like a balloon. If you blow in the balloon, you can push through a constant rate, but the pressure inside the balloon start rising. That's why pressure will rise, but your flow will remain constant. And your tidal volume will also rise. The balloon volume will also rise. So volume will also rise. So this is the change in the volume. This is change in the pressure. This is the flow. And all are happening against the time. Correct? Now, from the total peak inspiratory pressure, some pressure is of the airway and some pressure is of the lung alveoli. So to know what is the lung alveoli pressure which is required to keep the alveoli open, means plateau pressure, we need to give an inspiratory pause. What will happen in inspiratory pause? During inspiration, the movement of the air in the airway will stop. So there will be drop in the pressure. It will come to a standstill, and this pressure at which it becomes plateau, it is known as plateau pressure, which will be your alveolar pressure, pressure required to keep the lung open in that particular alveoli. That's why any ideas when we say the plateau pressure is high, means lungs are getting stiff. It's high force is required to keep the lung alveoli open. You got my point? This is the pressure graph, pressure time graph. This is the flow time graph. In flow time graph, you have make the flow constant. But during inspiration, but during exhalation, the air will come out. Okay. In volume cannot be negative. देयर विल ऑलवेज बी लंग एयर इन द लंग एल्वी और लंग पैरेन्काइमा. तो वॉल्यूम विल गो अप एंड देन विल गो डाउन. टाइडल वॉल्यूम विल गो अपसाइड इन द लंग एंड देन इट विल एक्सहेल. सो दिस इज द वे. दिस इज वॉल्यूम कंट्रोल. दिस इज वॉल्यूम कंट्रोल. नाउ थिंग्स चेंजेस इन प्रेशर कंट्रोल. इन प्रेशर कंट्रोल व्हाट हैपेंस लेट्स सी. नाउ इन प्रेशर कंट्रोल what will be the constant here in pressure control?
Pressure
will remain constant. So pressure graph will be, it will reach, pressure will, you are fixed that this much 40 or 50 or 30, whatever pressure should be there. So inspiration will start, trigger, a breath will be triggered and your pressure will remain constant. Right? So, pressure will remain constant throughout. But always, in pressure control mode, your flow graph is always a descending type. Understand? I want to blow certain amount of air with certain amount of pressure in the lung. But what will happen if the pressure in the tubing I have to kept at a certain level, when I will start blowing, there will be the lung as at the minimal pressure. When you start blowing, the lung will provide you resistance. So pressure will increase. But because I have to keep the pressure constant, it will start decreasing the flow. Like this, it will not be constant like this. It not be constant. If the flow is constant during the pressure control mode, at the start of inspiration, the lung is at the minimal pressure which is offering the resistance. As soon as you start the inspiration, the air which is going inside the lung is also producing some resistance and the pressure will increase. But we can't allow the pressure to increase, so pressure needs to remain constant. So flow will gradually decrease from the start of inspiration to the end of inspiration. So it will also always be at like this graph. The flow will be at the start, it will be at the maximum and then it will start dropping. In always pressure control mode, in all, no excuse for this, your flow graph will be a descending ramp. And what will happen to volume? Volume will remain the same because same amount of air is going, but the amount of volume which is being delivered to the patient will vary because we have kept the pressure constant. At this pressure, depending upon the airway resistance, the stiffness of the lung, the amount of volume may change. Volume may go to 400, 450 or 500 or 300 and will drop. Understood this too? And now when the pressure will drop, again the flow will in the reverse direction. So this is how your graph will look, flow time graph will look in your pressure support mode, pressure control mode, sorry, control mode on pressure control. This will be your pressure graph in pressure control mode and volume remains the same, but volume, height and area under the graph varies according to the condition of the lung. You got this much point? This is not negative flow. This means the flow is from patient to ventilator. Anything above the line x-axis is from ventilator towards the patient. This means this thing is square shaped graph, means we have set a particular variable which will remain constant throughout the cycle, full whole breath. Here the pressure is constant. In volume control, we have kept the flow constant. The pressure will vary. And volume in almost both the control modes will remain the same. Only thing in pressure control, the it can change its area under the graph depending upon the lung's condition. You understood this much point? Now, what can happen? Just to elaborate, what can happen? What can happen in certain scenarios? After that, we will switch to the loops and will then end. Suppose suppose you are having patient on control mode ventilation, ठीक है, we'll see this. A patient on control mode ventilation and who is on volume control. Volume control. In volume control, what is the fixed constant? Volume, and flow is constant. The pressure will change. Now, so in so this suppose here the breath is triggered in all three cases. Breath is triggered, so there will be a constant flow throughout this breath cycle. Here the pressure will rise and here tidal volume will rise, but in all those all three graphs there is no negative deflection. Here there is no negative deflection, everything is above the x-axis. That means the breath is generated by the ventilator at every 6 minutes or 3 minutes depending upon the respiratory rate. Now in such scenario, if the patient sucks air, now it is converted into assist control mode, means patient has triggered. So what will happen in the trigger? Will the volume go down? Will the volume of the lung go down? No,
no.
It has sucked the air, it will not go down. What happened to pressure and flow? Will the flow go down? No, because flow is towards the patient, it will not go. Will the pressure in the tube will go down? Yes, because there is a negative suction. Patient has sucked the air. This is the negative pressure which we generate during inspiration. The ventilator pushes it by positive ventilation. Once it is created a negative pressure in the tubing, then the air will be pushed with a positive pressure. So there will be a deflection in the pressure form. It will be like this. So there is a drop in the pressure and then this breath is triggered. Flow will remain the same because flow cannot be negative because movement of air is towards the patient. Volume will also not negative because the volume of air is being pushed towards the patient. So there will be only a negative deflection in the pressure graph, because in the tubing you have sucked, patient has sucked through a negative pressure. Got my point? Now here the expiration ends, means expiration started. Here also that expiration phase and exhalation starts. Now what happens if the next breath should start here when the exhalation gets completed? Here it should start again. It should start again when the exhalation. Suppose if you are seeing on the graph that breath is triggered here only. This exhalation graph of the flow is not able to touch the baseline and this breath starts here. So what will it will do? It will not allow the carbon dioxide or exhalation expiratory time to get finished. And if the breath starts from here, what will happen? The patient will start retaining CO2 because you are not allowing the CO2 or exhalation to complete. Over a period of time, this will generate hypercarbia and autopeep. Autopeep will generate. How to check for the autopeep? You should press the expiratory pause button. When you will, at the end of expiration, expiratory pause button will be paused, and the amount of peep which is there inside the lung, which is keeping the alveoli open, that will give intrinsic peep. Okay, this is the dynamic hyperinflammation. So if you are seeing in this expiratory graph, expiratory scale, if your inspiration is starting before this line is touching to the baseline, that means your inspiration is started before the exhalation has been completed. So this way you can know, oh, something is wrong. My patient will end up in retaining the CO2 over a period of hours. And this is causing dynamic inflation. This you got, this patient has triggered the breath. Now, in SIMV mode or pressure support mode, then we get sine waves. This much you understood? Now, in SIMV or spontaneous mode ventilation, I will take an example of SIMV so that we can get to know what is spontaneous breath and what is assisted breath. सपोज वी सी द वॉल्यूम, है ना, हियर दिस विल बी योर सिंपली स्पॉन्टेनियस ब्रेथ, नो सपोर्ट फ्रॉम वेंटिलेटर पेशेंट, नो सपोर्ट फ्रॉम द वेंटिलेटर, बट इन प्रेशर सपोर्ट वी से ना प्रेशर अबाव पीप, है ना, वेयर वी डू वेन द पेशेंट ट्रिगर्स ए ब्रेथ द वेंटिलेटर प्रोवाइड सपोर्ट एंड देन यू जनरेट ए वेव. सो दिस इज एन असिस्टेड ब्रेथ, दिस इज अ प्रेशर सपोर्ट सपोर्टेड ब्रेथ एंड दिस इज योर स्पॉन्टेनियस ब्रेथ. स्पॉन्टेनियस ब्रेथ्स विल बी वेरी लिटिल 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 अंटिल अनलेस दे आर सपोर्टेड बाय द वेंटिलेटर. इन वेंटिलेटर सपोर्टेड ब्रेथ्स विद प्रेशर सपोर्ट और सीपैप मोड वॉट एवर के एज सून एज इज ट्रिगर्स द वेंटिलेटर प्रोवाइड्स द सपोर्ट टू गिव फुल टाइडल वॉल्यूम. गॉट दिस पॉइंट? नाउ लूप्स, आई एम टेलिंग यू दिस इज द ओनली basic mechanics you require to understand all the graphics which is going on the ventilator. When we will see the troubleshooting and an alarms na, you will understand what is changing. We'll see some graphs on the ventilator also, so you need to understand. Hopefully after this session we can go to the ventilator bedside and also see how these graphs are coming. You will understand in a better way. Now loops, we have three variables: pressure, flow and volume. So volume will remain in both, so pressure volume and flow volume. Understand this. If you have a balloon, you start inflating the balloon. What happens? For a certain period of time, there is no change in the balloon volume. Got it? After a time, balloon expands very fast. And when it reaches its peak, the more you air the push, either it will blow up or it will not expand. Only this thing can happen. So that is what? Volume and pressure. Here we have volume and here we have pressure. You are getting? So, suppose we are increasing the pressure, but still now there is no change in the volume. And at one point, suddenly the balloon starts blowing up, means the lungs start getting inflated. Then, particular change, there will, this is volume should go up, na? Here pressure is going, so it will start like this. Pressure is increasing in this direction, till this point, there was no change in the volume, so y-axis remains the same. And after a certain point, suddenly the volume of the balloon or lung started thing, and after a point it reach where any increase in the pressure also there will be no change in the volume. So where this is lower inflation point LIP and this is upper inflation point. You will get to see these terminologies in your books. Got my point? Lower inflation point is the pressure required to overcome the resistance by the lung to get it inflated. So at this point the lung suddenly starts opening up, and at from this point whatever amount of pressure you do it will not. That's why in our target is to ventilate the patient between upper inflation point and lower inflation point to avoid injury to the other normal alveoli. That's why we ventilate under this pressure. And once your inspiration is over, then this graphs come like that. Expiration follows a delayed thing. Expiration will be a more or less smooth thing, it will be delayed. So this is the loop. So this is volume pressure. You are applying pressure and here the volume in the lung is changing. You are applying pressure at up to a certain limit, there is no change in the volume of the lung, but suddenly the lung starts expanding. So point where the lung starts expanding is called lower inflation point. Then it goes in this direction and up when it reaches a certain limit, when you whatever amount of pressure you do, the lung will not expand or it will have a barotrauma. So that is called upper inflation point. And when you stop the pressure, putting the pressure, then the exhalation comes. So this is now to understand more, let's see an example. Suppose you have a patient who have a restrictive lung disease, means IPF patient, lungs are fibrosed. So what will happen? You will keep on putting the pressure, but the lung will not expand. After a certain point, it has crossed so much pressure has been now it will slightly expand like this, you know. But even after that, it will not expand to that volume which it should be in a normal length. So it will expand and then the shift of loop towards the right. The more shift towards the right, that means if the patient is having respiratory restrictive lung disease. With increasing, even after increasing the pressure, the lung is not expanding, and even it is expanding, it is not expanding to that limit which it should expand. For a given pressure, the change in volume is very low. So it will be restrictive lung disease. Now consider another scenario, an emphysematous chest or COPD chest. What will happen? You blow a certain amount of pressure, means more compliant lung. You put give just a little amount of pressure, it will blow like this. It will have a huge volume, and but exhalation will be prolonged. So this is usually seen in emphysematous COPD patient, where the parenchyma disease elastase is lost. So they expand. The problem is with the exhalation. The exhalation will be prolonged. So any shift towards the left is suggestive of obstructive lung disease of the airway. You get an idea? We are just trying to understand the basic concept. We'll have different lectures on this to understand with different example. But just to know what is happening on the patient ventilator graphs, we are understanding this. And the last is, we have considered volume pressure, then volume and flow. We'll change it to flow. This is the least which we use, but it is most commonly used in spirometry. Here is volume, this is flow. Here the loop is like this actually. Loop is like this. This is your expiration, this is your inspiration. So as soon as the flow increases, your volume increases and reaches a particular limit, then drops to the zero, then it goes on like this. So this graph we don't use very much in detail on ventilator patients, but in spirometry this graph has very much value. So we'll discuss this graph in detail when we see our real graphics. So point is, you need to understand 3-4 things. One, you have 4 types of graphs: square, ascending, descending, sine pattern. Then you need to know the concept of what is the trigger in that particular breath. Then what is the cycle, the set parameter, the control parameter, which will change from inspiration to expiration. Third is your limit. What is the parameter which is set constant during this particular limit? It will not change from inspiration, but what is the limit? Then you need have 5 types of graphs. Out of these, 3 are scalars which are plotted against the time, 2 are which are loops which are amongst themselves. Only thing we have to consider is pressure, volume and flow. So there will be a pressure time graph, there will be a flow time graph, there will be a volume time graph, and in the loops there will be pressure volume or flow volume. Now after understanding this basic concept, you can ask the questions on the forum or the website, and what we can have discussion also. We'll just go near the ventilator and we'll see how those loops are happening in the real time in the patient ventilator, how this come up. These are the only loops which are. You need to master at least the scalars, flow time, volume time, or you need to master 3 graphs. By looking at these three graphs, you can identify 99% of the problems which is happening with the patient. For now, we just go to the patient bedside and we'll see these graphs in detail, and you can identify what are these graphs. So this is the live ICU environment. This is the ventilator. Now you can see, you can identify, this is volume and time graph. Getting my point? This is the inspiration. This portion, this green line is inspiration, and this is the expiration. So it is volume, and volume cannot be negative. So it remains always above the baseline. What is this? This is flow. By looking at the graph, you can see that this is inspiration, and any problem you are seeing in the flow? सी सी दिस हाँ जस्ट सी दैट ग्रीन लाइन इंस्पिरेशन इज नॉट एबल टू टच द बेस लाइन एंड द एक्सप्रेशन इज स्टार्टिंग सो इन दिस पेशेंट वॉट इज हैपनिंग इंस्पिरेशन इज नॉट गेटिंग कम्प्लीटेड प्रॉपरली एंड हियर योर इंस्पिरेशन स्टार्ट दैट्स द इशू एंड दिस एक्सप्रेशन इज गेटिंग टच बट यू कैन सी हियर सर्टन पोर्शन ऑफ द टाइम इट रिमेन्स हियर ऑन द बेस लाइन दिस सम अमाउंट सो यू आर लूजिंग दिस स्पेस Nothing is happening when after it touches the baseline. So what we can do is we can slightly increase the inspiratory time so that we can give proper weight to this patient and we here that will compensate with the expiratory part. Now we can change the graph also. This is volume time and this is flow time. We need to change it to plot setup. So we'll change this plot 1 to pressure time.
Pressure.
See, you can see five things are only coming on this thing. Pressure time scalar, volume time scalar, flow time scalar and two loops. Pressure volume loop and flow volume loop. These are only the five graphs which comes in this ventilator. Only you need to master these. Out of these three, these scalars, these three graphs you master, you can diagnose anything which is happening with the patient. Now we'll switch the plot one to pressure time. So in pressure time, what we will get? We'll get a rising pressure, then a declining pressure. So this will change. Now see, getting pressure rising, reaching a plateau and drop. Now if you have to see what is the and you see this is above the baseline. This is the 5 is the peep, which we have kept. Baseline peep. You see 0 and 5. There is a so this is the peep. That's why. Now to see whether what is our airway pressure and what is our plateau pressure, we will give an inspiratory pause. So here we will able to find out what is the plateau pressure and what is the inspiratory pressure. The patient, because it's on sedation and on relaxant, will try to give it. We'll unfreeze once more, we'll give a pause when it starts here. See, at the end of inspiration, it will stop. Inspiration, it will stopping. It's the pause, and then drop. Then it will drop. See, here the plateau is coming. 19 is out of this 24, 19 is the plateau pressure, and 5 is the airway pressure. We'll again unfreeze and we'll start from here so that we get a full that thing. Let the breath end here, and I will give inspiratory pause here. Now I have given inspiratory pressure. Now this is going down for the pause is going, then it suddenly it will drop. See, got this? Out of this total pressure, this much is the plateau pressure and 24 is the peak, 20 is the plateau. So 4 is the airway pressure, 20 is the plateau pressure. Suppose in this, if the airway pressure becomes 30 and your plateau remains 20, that means there is an airway problem. There is a problem from the airway. There is a bronchospasm, tube nicking and all those things. If the plateau pressure is increasing, that means there is a parenchymal disease, pneumothorax, pulmonary edema, fibrosis, that all things. You are understanding now this? Now, we want to see the loops also. So, we'll check the loop also. So, plot one will be pressure volume. You understand the pressure volume loop? See, this is the lower inflation point, this is the higher inflation point, and this is the exhalation. You are applying the pressure, but at this point suddenly the volume increases, and at this point it will not increase, and then it comes down. So this is the pressure volume loop. Understanding this? Now if on this loop, the graph started shifting towards that. That means the lung parenchyma is at the problem. If it shifts towards this side, then that is the airway problem. You understanding this loop?
Yes.
Now, flow volume. See, flow volume. This is your inspiration, and this is expiration. Okay? Understood? So again, we'll plot the pressure. Volume time and flow time. Always keep an eye on flow time graph. It is very important. Thank you.
Thank you.